How's it going, everybody? My name is Amie Tyler. If you would do me a favor, we are on the road to 500 subs. So if you can hit that like, that subscribe button, I would really appreciate it. I'm going to be reacting to the Rolling Stones' Sweet Sounds of Heaven featuring Lady Gaga. This was a request by Omega SV, and so I wanted to give a shout out to them for putting that in the comments. If you'd like me to react to any other future things, again, you'll want to put those in the comments as well. I don't know much about this song. Actually, I don't know anything about this song. I don't really listen to the Rolling Stones. And so this will be a new reaction for me. I know a little bit about the Stones. I like their shirt with the mouth and the tongue. I understand. I mean, I like Keith Richards. He's an incredible guitarist. And then obviously Mick Jagger has got a lot of energy. And but I don't know anything about this song. I don't know if it's going to be, you know, a blasting song, you know, with a bunch of synth, or if it's just going to be a mellow song. I'm looking at the anesthetic here. It looks like, just going based off the anesthetic again, that this is probably going to start out very, very mellow, to kind of go with the vibe, with the purples and the pinks, but we will, and you know, the blues, under the drums. But again, it's just the intro shot. Who knows? It could be a blasting song. We'll find out. I have a suspicion it's going to be a mellow song, just looking at the anesthetic, but what do I know? I don't know anything, but, enough about this. Let's, get into this, and let's see what this song is all about. Bluesy. Well, I wasn't expecting that.
I hear the sweet, sweet sound of heaven.
Okay. So let me pause it here. I was not expecting this to be a bluesy song. I will say, well, based on the song Sweet Sounds of Heaven, you kind of knew where this song was going to go. This is a sweet sound of heaven. Yeah. I do love the Stones. Again, I don't know much about, I don't listen to them very often, but the stuff I, you know, this is very, 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 from what I know about them, very different. What I love about Keith Richards is, man, this guy, he's got personality. They definitely know their music. They definitely know their style. They definitely have the look, the feel. They've been doing this for a very long time, so it's kind of exciting. But let's get into the Sweet Sounds of Heaven. Let's see what they're going to tell us.
Falling down,
Sweet Sounds of Heaven, falling down
to this earth.
Yeah, let's have heaven's sounds fall down to earth. What do you hear? Tell me, Mick Jagger.
Sweetest sound
of heaven.
Drifting down. Drifting down.
It's drifting down from where?
To this earth.
It's going to the earth. Could be a gospel song.
Bless the Father. Bless the Son.
Okay. Wait.
Hear the sound of...
All right. You know, I'm a pastor, so when they're talking about, bless, you know, the Father, the Son, I was waiting to see if he's going to say Holy Ghost, but are they going to go Christian on me? I don't think so. The Stones aren't Christian. They're not even close to Christian. In fact, I know that Keith Richards, I read in an interview once, and it was Christian Today or something like that, way back in like the 90s, and don't quote me on the year, but it was a while ago. And he was interviewed by this magazine. He's like, well, you know, what are you going to do when you stand before God on that day? And Keith Richards in a way that only Keith Richards would do, he's like, well, I'm going to tell God I'm the Rolling Stones. And I just like, oh brother, you don't have, I'll tell you what you're going to do when you stand before God. Like all of us, we're going to fall on our faces as though dead and worship. However, I know Keith Richards has an incredible story. I know that. There's another story. Don't know if it's true, but I heard that he took his father's ashes and he snorted it when he was on one of his drunk binges. And the rumor is that Keith Richards is one that just never dies. Sadly, that's not true. The Word of God says that it is appointed for a man once to die and then the judgment. But I'm on a tangent. This song is beautiful. And I love the feel of it. It's just so, I can't wait to see what Lady Gaga's going to do when that comes on. So let's get back to it. I mean, why didn't back? Just a hair.
That's the song.
Tremors in the pocket.
Through the valley, and it bursts.
See, look at Jagger, such.
Hold on.
Okay, I do have to say this. Mick Jagger is such an incredible frontman. I mean, the guy's in his 70s, and he's on his knees, and he's doing a mellow song, and he's all about it, and he's all over the place. And this is a song that. I think most people today would just be standing there very still and just seeing it, maybe moving their hands. And he's just so animated and so he's such an incredible front person. This is why they've had a lot of success in so long. Not only the great musicianship, but he's just an incredible front man. sorry, that just kind of impressed me. So go Mick Jagger. I'm sorry. I gotta say this. I wonder if Mick Jagger was one of those kids where he never sat still, you know, and you're trying to defeat him like, here comes the plane, and he's just like, ah, all over the place. He probably was that kind of person. I could picture him just spinning like the Tasmanian devil as a teenager and just kind of a tornado everywhere he went. Just find that very, very amusing. It's worked out for him, not gonna lie. He has been very successful in his musical endeavors as a frontman. Kudos to him. So, yeah, let's hit this back. Rewind this a tad and preach to us, Mick Jagger. Tell us what's going on. Yeah, talk to your guitarist. I have a guitar like that. Right there.
I smell the sweet.
Woo! Dude, Gaga is just, hold on. Okay, I was not expecting her to come out right then. I was thinking it's a feature. She was going to come out in a bigger part of the song. Man, look at that outfit. She's amazing. She always looks amazing. And I wish I could pull off something like that, but there's no way I'd be able to wear something like that. You wouldn't want to see it anyways. However, she is beautiful, and her voice and her range, and, you know, she does these collabs with, like, Tony Bennett, and then with Mick Jagger, and then she's got all of her rock stuff. It's just, she did a collab with Metallica and did a live thing there. It's just incredibly fluid in her ability to really go into any genre or any type of song and just own it. I'm not even going to remember Mick Jagger with Lady Gaga here because her voice is whoo. But knowing Mick Jagger, they're probably going to try and outdo each other. Let's see how this goes. I'm really super excited about this one. I'm going to kick it back because I was not expecting her to come back in on that one. Oh, there she is. Yeah.
I smell the sweet.
Her voice. Yeah, I feel it. I feel it. Heaven's coming down. They have such great chemistry together. This is so good.
I hear the sweet sound. The sweet sound of children.
Oh, sorry. I gotta touch on this one again. So, what I really find interesting here is the fact that both of them just kind of suck you into the performance. They're so good. They're just appealing to the eye. Even what Jack is wearing is very simple, and with what Lady Gaga's wearing is very, very glamorous. The chemistry is so good. They're communicating, and they're doing their little Q&A thing, and they're singing together, and it's actually very, very fun and beautiful to watch. In fact, I would say this is a song that probably doesn't get a lot of people, you know, jumping around, bopping their heads, but these guys do. These guys here, whoo, they get you into it. It's exciting. I'm going to run it back when she walks out because she's so good. Ugh, I love Gaga. This great, great, great song. Yeah. Yeah, I can smell the sweet sound of heaven. Tell me about it. Yeah. Keith Richards doesn't know what to do back there.
I hear the sweet sound. The sweet sound.
It almost looks like they're fighting with each other. You shut the music off and you just get them in their face like that. Do the dishes. You haven't cleaned up. I'm a woman. You don't tell me what to do. Oh, sorry. Oh, my goodness. They're so good. Look at the smile on his face. He's like, wow, this is so incredibly good. They're just nailing the parts together. Again, the anesthetic behind this, you've got the reds, the purples, the striped shirt, it's just got that incredible local music vibe, but also it's got that theater vibe. It's also got that big arena vibe, but all compressed into one little performance, and it is incredible. And they sound so good together. Listen to this note. Let's hit it. There it is. Okay. I may have to renege on what I said. Because I assume that Lady Gaga is going to take over, and she has, and that Mick Jagger is going to disappear, but he is not going to disappear. They are equally doing this performance together, and they both are owning it, and it sounds incredible. Incredible. I'm getting lost in the music itself, so it's hard to... It's just so appealing to the eyes. So appealing. Crowd's enjoying it. I'm enjoying it. Great cinematography. Great camera work. Oh, to see them up close like that would be amazing. Got all the right elements for a good song. It's big. Even okay, let's kick that back again. Hold on here. I want to show you this right here. Look at this smile. I think it's right here. Let's see if this is it. No, not there. Right? Look at Richard. Look at that smile. They know that the vocals are nailing it. In fact, the vocals are so good that you forget, minus the groove being in the pocket, you forget that Richards is there and that these other people are there because, I mean, the focal point is on Gaga and on Mick Jagger. And he's feeling it. You know he's feeling it. Look at this smile. Look at this grin. He's just like, yeah, I'm loving it. So good. It's so good. Let's kick it back here. And go. Play loud. Play loud. Let it burn. Fill the clouds. She's a looks amazing. Feel the heat. Her hair looks amazing, by the way. You know, I'm so glad no one's ever told Mick Jagger to act your age, because he does not act his age at all. He runs around like he's 15 years old, and this is a mellow song, and he's just impressive. That's all I gotta say. It's very impressive. Looks like they're fighting with each other, though. In a good way. Yeah, you... Uh-oh, it's gonna get violent now! Look how much fun they're having! They are having so much fun! Oh, this is what I love about music. One of the things I love about being a musician is you can take any emotion you want and you can vocalize it in the music. And you can bring people on a journey with you. You can make them feel angry. You can make them feel sad. You can make them feel depressed. You can make them feel overjoyed. Or you could just make them feel good. And this is one of those songs that probably just listening to it, it's got a decent vibe. It's a decent song. It's a great song, actually. I'm not going to say anything less than that. But watching them perform the song, it just makes you feel good. It just feels good inside. It's just a lot of fun to watch this. Gaga is just an incredible performer. Mick Jagger, incredible performer. And the musicians in the background, they don't know what to do because they've got to give the stage to these incredible frontmen and frontwomen. It's so good. So good. Oh, and Jagger, hit that note. Oh, you can't. Such a great venue. I feel like I'm at a mass revival right now. Come to Jesus, my friends.
Oh yeah, this one gets 5 stars.
So good, so good. Such a great, great performance, such a great song. They are loving each other.
Thank you.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So good. You don't want it to stop. Is it gonna keep going? Oh, let's go a little bit further with this one. Okay. Woo! Look at the smile on her face. They're just having a great time. But like I said, I feel like I'm at some kind of revival, you know, like I'm at a black church, you know, and I mean, in such there's such a powerful experience. It's like, come on. And man, they are bringing the vibe and the feel and the energy to this performance. They have outdone themselves. So good. Ooh, it's coming down. Oh, this is where Gaga takes over. Right here. He's like, no, you're not taking over. They're having so much fun. Oh, they got everyone on their feet. Look at that. This is such a mellow song. You wouldn't normally be doing this on this song. Time to get into a mosh pit. Yeah. Mick Jagger's not going to let Gaga take over. Gaga's not going to let Mick Jagger take over. They're both incredible performers. That is an incredible performance. Aww. They sound amazing. They're so good at what they do. Is that it? Yeah, that's it.
Let's take it back.
Ugh, love that, love that, love that, love that. Yeah. Was that the closer of their show? Gosh, Gaga looks good with even messy hair. Okay. So good. We'll just minimize this real quick so we can have a conversation. Yeah. Those two. Well, I was impressed, not gonna lie. Such an incredible song. Sweet Sounds of Heaven. Very gospel-y, very bluesy, very in the pocket, you know. And Mick Jagger could have handled that song on his own. He was doing a really incredible job. He's an incredible front man. But you see the level of excitement because we know who Gaga is, and Gaga is phenomenal. And you get these two incredible front men, front women up there trying to outdo each other but not trying to compete. Doing it very well, enjoying it, just having fun, having a good time, and it makes you feel good. It makes you feel good. So, there's my reaction. Again, hit that like and subscribe button. Throw in the comments another song that you'd like me to react to, and we will get at it. Thank you guys, and I will see you around. God bless you.